According to a new analysis of the economic costs to the state of Texas of Republican Governor Greg Abbott's recent border stunt, where he forced these long inspections of all of these trucks coming from Mexico to the United States, you know, produce, manufacturing materials, things like that. Basically, in case you forgot about it, that whole week where he intentionally disrupted the supply chain. A new analysis has found that the economic loss to the state of Texas was $4.2 billion. By slowing commerce in the state in an attempt to screw over President Biden, because that's what this was, for 1 week, $4.2 billion that would have gone into the state of Texas, that would have been economic activity rippling through their state economy, gone because Greg Abbott wanted to pull this ridiculous political theater down at the southern border, of course, to go along with all of the other political theater that he has going on along the southern border. And economists are telling us right now that there's probably no way to ever get a real handle on the true economic costs, not just to Texas, but to the entire country. Because let's not forget, these goods, these products, these things coming in, not all of them were just going to Texas. There were car manufacturing pieces in there, right? Things used to manufacture cars. A lot of those are going up north. And they got held up for days. And economists are telling us, however, that it could be weeks, if not months, before the supply chain is able to kind of fix itself due to this 1 week of slowdown. And again, Abbott knew what he was doing. He did this to screw over the supply chain. We're already having supply chain issues here in the United States. That's not a, you know, controversial point. Yes, it's happening. Yes, it's bad. Yes, it's screwing over consumers. It's giving corporations the green light to gouge us on prices because they can pretend it's due to scarcity, but it's really due to greed. Abbott tried to capitalize on that to make the supply chain worse because that is a big hit against President Biden. Look at the polls. That's the number one issue right now. People blame him for it. Abbott wanted to make it worse for him. All he did was screw over mostly Texans, but to a degree, literally everybody else in this country. This petty little fraction of a man screwed every single one of us over. And unfortunately, Texas is probably going to reelect him this year because they just love that. They don't care about the $4.2 billion the state lost. Abbott doesn't care about the $4.2 billion the state lost. As long as he gets to own the libs, right? Oh, we got them good on this one, boys. No. Your state suffered. The rest of the country is going to suffer. You did this intentionally because you're a piece of crap. Because you want to use these migrants and these immigrants as your political props. It's not working so well for you nationally. But of course, as is always the case, down in Texas, they absolutely love them. And like I said, probably going to give them yet another term when they get the chance to do that this November. So Texas, you know what you got ahead of you. Abbott's shown you he hasn't been shy about it. He's going to continue to rake you over the coals in the off chance maybe it'll affect Biden just a little bit. You're the ones paying the real price, not President Biden. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for fresh content every single day of the week. Just smash that subscribe button, and of course, don't forget to like, comment, and share the video.